What's up? It's Kalei. This video is all about testing out Natasha Denona's new bronze eyeshadow palette. I purchased the cheek palette, but I want this to focus on the eyeshadow palette. A video will be featuring the cheek palette coming soon, so don't forget to subscribe to this channel and turn on alerts so you don't miss it. This video is going to be one of many. If you're buying products under my recommendation, I want to help you get the most out of it. So this is one of many videos that I'm going to do like it. I still plan to do unboxings and first impressions, but I want this to be one of the main things that I do here on my channel, especially if you're buying things that I recommend. So getting started, I'm going to do my brows. I'm using Precisely My Brow from Benefit Cosmetics, and I'm just filling in the sections of brows where I'm very sparse and just making sure I'm using the 24-hour brow setter to set it in place. And then I'm picking up Deep Dive. This is the deepest shade in the palette, the only dark shade in the palette, and I really like it. I started with this color because it is the darkest and those tend to be the most driest. And this is my first Natasha Denona palette, so she always starts with dark colors, and I thought, why not? So I just applied that to the lash line. I'll apply it to the lower lash line very soon. I picked up Suntan just as a transitional shade, just to see what it does. I have no goal of this look at all, just trying. So then I picked up True Copper, and I noticed very quickly I did not like it applied with a brush, so I used my fingers. I have seen Natasha use brushes, but she might have better brushes for this purpose. They could be wet. There are so many factors into that, so I'm just going to go ahead and use my finger until I figure out the way that I enjoy applying it, but so far finger is always my favorite with shimmers. So then next I wanted to try out the Deep Dive shade over the shimmer shades. Sometimes that can get very muddy and it won't blend well, but surprisingly this did that, so I'm giving it a thumbs up for that. And then I'm using it as a liner on the lower lash line and just smoking it out, blowing it out, seeing how far I can get with it, how nice and clean I can keep it. And so far I really enjoy how it blends out and just disappears into the skin after you've blended out for a while. I did notice that this palette doesn't really have a good brow bone highlight color. It does, in my opinion, it's very shimmery. So I had to use a different one, but it's not like a big deal, but I thought I would put that out there. But now I'm just curling my lashes and prepping it for Urban Decay's Lash Freak Mascara. This is brand new. If you've been with me for a while, you know waterproof mascara is my top choice, but this is not waterproof and it has not smudged on me. And I've been out in the humid heat, you guys. So far so good with that one. And then I'm gonna go back to the Natasha Denona Bronze Eye Palette and just use True Bronze to highlight the inner corner and go in with Benefit Cosmetics Air Stick foundation. This is really good, you guys. This is all I've been wearing for a little bit because I haven't been wearing a ton of foundation for video purposes. I do that, but I'm usually wearing a mask. I'm not about to waste my lipstick and my foundation and stuff for the mask to mess it up. So this is for video purposes because I want you to see the look come together as a whole, not just the eyes. So I'm also just gonna bronze the face very lightly. A new product that I have been enjoying is from Honest Beauty. It's the setting powder. It's a little powdery, but nothing too crazy. I've been enjoying it. And then of course, the Becca Gradient Glow Highlighter and N07 Blush. My fave. You guys know the color. Say it with me. Peach Velvet. So then of course, I'm using Laura Mercier's Rock to line the lips, get it ready for the next product, which is NYX Cosmetics Soft Matte Lip Cream in London. You know my combination. Yes, girl. It's my favorite combination, you guys. I don't think I would ever stop doing it.